Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you radar range measurement. I'll explain you each and every steps of how range of radar that is measured by radar system. So first of all, you should know how transmission of signal is happening and how reflected receive signal that comes to radar system. So in my earlier videos, I have explained you monostatic radar system. In monostatic radar system, we have one antenna that is connected with duplexer, and duplexer is connected with transmitter and receiver system. See, with radar system, there are three major elements: transmitter, receiver, and antenna. Here, duplexer is separating transmitter and receiver, and because of duplexer, we just need one antenna over here with monostatic radar system. See, transmitter is providing high power signal to this antenna that is getting radiated in the space, and as if any object is coming, then there will be reflection of signal. So this antenna that will be transmitting high power signal over here, that signal will be having strength in terms of kilowatts to megawatts, and as if object is there in between that space, then there will be reflected signal towards antenna. That reflected signal that will be very weak. Reflected signal wave that is having power in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 to 10 to the power minus 15. So here, transmitter that is operating at high power in terms of kilowatts to megawatts, and here receiver that is operating with very low power in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 volt to 10 to the power minus 15 volt. Separation of transmitter and receiver that is done with the use of duplexer. See, duplexer does what? Duplexer simply forwards signal of transmitter to antenna, and as if this antenna is receiving reflected wave, then that reflected signal that is forwarded to receiver over here. So here duplexer is isolating high power transmitter and low power receiver. So role of duplexer that is operating with transmitter and received signal, it will be isolating high power transmitter and low power receiver. And because of duplexer, in monostatic radar system, we need one antenna only. See, as and when you have one antenna with radar system, you can say it is monostatic radar system. Here we have only one antenna, so we have monostatic radar system where transmitter and receiver that is separated by duplexer. So that is how radar is functioning. But how to identify range? So for that, let me show this propagation of waves again. Let us say here transmitter is sending high power signal over here, during which signal will be traveled by distance r. After reflection, again that signal that is coming back to antenna, during which also it will be traveling by distance r. So in total, signal will be traveled by 2r distance. First r distance, first range distance that is happening during transmission, and second range distance that is happening during reflection of wave. So in total, wave is traveling by 2r distance. Now how to identify range? See, for that you need to understand this transmission and reception with respect to time. So here, see, I'll be showing you waveforms of transmitter and waveforms of receiver. Here, transmitter is transmitting high power signal. So you can observe here, we have transmitted signal. So during this pulse width, we are transmitting high frequency through this antenna in the space. And that is traveling in the space. And after some delay, reflected signal will come back to antenna. So here, receiver will be receiving reflected echo signal over here. So if you observe delay in between transmitter and receiver, then that delay is total propagation time. So total propagation time, now that we have, and here during this total propagation time, distance covered by this wave, that is r plus r 2r, right? See, here we are transmitting electromagnetic waves. So here, whatever electromagnetic waves that we are transmitting, that is having velocity of light, and that is fixed. For free space, it is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So based on velocity equation, one can identify range. See, velocity, that is a velocity of light in free space over here, as we are transmitting electromagnetic waves, that is distance divided by time. Here distance is how much? R plus R, 2R. And here total propagation time, that is a delay in between signal of transmitter and receiver. And based on that delay, one can have total range over here. So if you simplify this, see, range will be velocity into time divided by 2. Why here divided by 2 is there? The reason is this signal that is traveled by 2R distance. So C is velocity of light in free space. P is total round trip time for signal propagation, right? That is how range calculation is there. Sometimes I have seen this range calculation that may be given to you in different forms. So you need to understand this range calculation. See, radar and range equation that I have told you, that is R is equals to velocity into propagation delay divided by 2. Here value of velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. If you substitute that, in that situation, you can have range in terms of propagation time. That will be, in terms of kilometer, it will be 0.15 into propagation time in terms of microsecond. So if you consider propagation time in terms of microsecond, then range in terms of kilometer will be 0.15 TP. I have seen this type of formula that is given to you sometimes in books. At that time, students used to say me like, sir, we are having some different formula. So it is not different. Here we are just substituting C is equals to 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by 2. So 3 by 2, that is 1.5. So 1.5 into 10 to the power 8. Right. Now, if you consider time in terms of microsecond, then you will have to divide it by 10 to the power 6. In that situation, now you will be having modified equation, that is 0.15 TP in terms of microsecond. Even I have seen some other equations even in terms of miles, right? So nautical mile, that range also can be given to you. So this is what nautical mile range, and that is 0.081 TP in terms of microsecond. See, this nautical mile, that is having relation with distance in terms of kilometer. So that relation also one should know. One nautical mile, that is equals to 1.852 kilometer. So if you substitute, one nautical mile is equals to this in terms of kilometer over here, then you will have to divide 0.15 with this and you will be getting 0.081, right? So these two equations that may be there in calculation sometimes. Otherwise, this equation is sufficient to calculate radar range in terms of propagation delay, right? So sometimes propagation delay may be given to you. Based on that also, you can identify radar range. Sometimes propagation delay may be given to you in terms of microsecond. At that time, you may need to calculate that radar range in terms of kilometer. At that time also, you can use this equation. Sometimes they may ask you to have a calculation of radar range in terms of nautical mile. In that case, you can use this equation. Even if you don't remember this equation, then also that is fine. But if you want to calculate range in terms of nautical mile, at that time, what you need to do is you need to find this radar range in terms of meter. After that, you just divide it by 1000. That will be there in terms of kilometer. After that, if you want that in terms of nautical mile, in that case, you just divide that by 1.852. That will be there in terms of nautical mile. That is how also you can proceed to solution of questions. I hope you have understood all those things. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.